How on earth does gorgeous swimsuit model Kate Upton debunk Karl Marx? Why, he's one of the most influential thinkers of the 19th century, and she gets paid for striking a pose. Quite easily, as a matter of fact. Stay tuned to find out how. Hello everyone, this is My Two Cents. If you've ever had a discussion with a Marxist, or just a socialist of any stripe, it probably wasn't long before they started telling you about class theory. They tell us that capitalism is the story of the bourgeoisie who own the means of production, and the proletariat who provide labor to the bourgeoisie in exchange for a wage. It's that simple. Two classes. And the bourgeoisie are exploiting the proletariat by extracting surplus value from their labor, constantly striving to lower wages and ensuring that the wealth inequality gap grows exponentially. This leads to a few bourgeoisie who spend their days swimming in piles of gold while everyone else groans in pain, hardly able to afford a crust of bread with their measly wages. Now, before any of you Marxists accuse me of misrepresenting Karl Marx's view of class theory, listen to noted Marxist professor Richard Wolff explain it himself.
The way class works in our society can best be understood if you think about how a business works. In most businesses, the people who do the work come 5 days a week, use their brains and muscles doing what the employer sets them as tasks, with the equipment and materials the employer provides. At the end of the day, they go home, and the employer keeps the fruits of their labor, which the employer then sells. And the goal of the employer is to get more money when he sells the output than it cost him to buy the tools, equipment, raw material, and hire those workers. Class is this difference between those who do the work, the overwhelming majority, and those who gather the profit into their hands.
Different socialists have slightly different terms for this concept. Bernie Sanders is fond of talking about the 1% and the 99%. But no matter what progressive you're talking to, they have some kind of very simple narrative about haves and have-nots, oppressor and oppressed. And what's more important, they're convinced that everyone is born into whatever class they're in. You're either part of the oppressive capitalist class or an oppressed labor worker. And even if there are some rare exceptions, the vast majority of people will never be able to change what class they're a part of, no matter how hard they work. So where did Marx go wrong? As I alluded to at the beginning, we're going to find the answer by looking to the beautiful and awe-inspiring swimsuit model, Kate Upton.
But no man can resist the siren call of mentally impaired supermodel Kate Upton.
What does Kate Upton have to do with a discussion of class theory, you may ask? Well, I want you to consider this question. Based on Marx's explanation of the capitalist class and the labor class, which class does Kate belong to? Kate doesn't own Guess or Sports Illustrated. She doesn't own the cameras or studios where she appears. Kate simply sells her labor in exchange for a wage, which according to Marx, would make her a member of the oppressed and exploited proletariat. Yet Kate has an estimated net worth of more than $10 million, which puts her in the top 1% of all Americans.
Almost all of the wealth and much of the income is going to the top 1%.
How can it be the case that Kate Upton is an oppressed labor worker, but simultaneously a member of the 1%? Well, quite simply, the difference is supply and demand. Kate's labor is far more valuable to the modeling agency than the labor of a janitor who cleans up after the photo shoot, or even the labor of a lesser-known model who is not as likely to sell a high volume of magazines and other products. According to models themselves, the vast majority of women in the modeling industry spend their days going to auditions, most of them being turned down and receiving no compensation. Those that are hired receive wages that are less than impressive, even if they secure the position on the cover of a magazine. The difference is that whether you believe she deserves it or not, Kate Upton has reached a level of notoriety where producers know that products with her body on the cover will sell. As such, they're all competing for Kate's labor, requiring them to offer increasingly higher amounts of money in order to get her to sign with them. Consider also persons in the professions of law, medicine, and the financial sector. Do lawyers, doctors, or financial advisors own any means of production? Typically, no. They provide labor in exchange for payment as well. However, because they've spent years developing specific skill sets that most of the population does not have, their labor is worth far more than the labor of burger flippers at McDonald's, again, as a result of supply and demand. Under capitalism, employers and employees alike are exchanging specific amounts of money for specific services because both parties are better off as a result. If they weren't, there would be no reason for making the exchange in the first place. So what then can be said to the minimum wage worker who's convinced he's being oppressed by the wealthy? Well, you have to ask yourself why it is that you're only being paid the wage you are. And the answer is that it can only be because there is a far greater supply of individuals who possess the skill set for which you're employed than there is demand. If you want to make more money, do some research. Find out what industries currently have a demand for qualified individuals and work to develop that particular skill set. If you think you can provide something specific that there is demand for, start your own business. Although this would be a lot easier were it not for pesky government regulations.
Peter, I'm afraid I'm here to shut you down. You're running an unlicensed business, and that's against the law.
In summary, by comparing business owners to supermodels, experts who provide intangible services, and minimum wage workers, we can see that there is not a system of oppressor and oppressed. There's only property, labor, and the voluntary exchange of both determined by supply and demand. If you're happy with your lot in life, great. If you'd like to make more money than you're currently making, maybe instead of advocating that the government steal it for you, you should start asking, what can I do to offer something unique that's in demand? Be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And that is my two cents. Take it for what it's worth. Thanks everyone for watching. If you liked this video, please hit like and subscribe. You can also hit the bell to ensure you're notified every time I upload a new video. This video was made possible by my patrons. If anyone else would like to donate and help ensure that I have the time and resources to keep putting out content, for just $1 a month on Patreon or Maker Support, you'll have your name listed in the end credits of every video and the link to one of your social media platforms listed in the description. You can also support the channel by purchasing My 2 Cents merchandise on Teespring. You can also follow me on Twitter, Minds.com, BitChute, WordPress, Gab, and iTunes. Uploads are every Thursday and Saturday, so stay tuned for more videos.